Welcome to this special webinar that we're doing. It's actually a book launch, you know, and the context is very interesting. We often say that the media is facing a crisis of credibility, and journalists have been on the receiving side of that criticism. And of course, a lot of us have tried to do some course correction, do some introspection. But now there's a whole way of looking at it. Sri Alok Mehta ji, renowned senior journalist and Padma Shri, he has come up with his book, Power, Press and Politics, which is an attempt to look at media closely and look at the ways we can address this criticism. And with me today, we have some eminent names from the world of journalism who would talk about, who have read this book, and they'll share their views. And Mehta ji is also here. I just want to introduce my panelists today who will be talking about it. We have Padma Shri, Sri Alok Mehta ji with us, who is also the former president of the Editors Guild of India and editorial director of ITV Network Hindi. We have Mr. Anand Narasimhan, executive editor, Network 18. We have with us Mr. Sachinanda Murthy, resident editor of Malayala Manorama and The Week. We have with us Ms. Rubika Liaquat, news anchor, popular presenter and journalist at ABP. And of course, Dr. Anurag Batra, chairman and editor-in-chief, BW Business World and Exchange for Media. Before we proceed and I ask my set of questions, I want to request everyone to just put up the book in front of the camera so we can have a quick screenshot. That is the way we do the photo shoot, the group photo now. Absolutely. Sagar. All right, no worries. All right. Perfect. Perfect. Thank you so much for joining us today. I want to go straight away with my first question to Sri Alok Mehta ji. So give me a sense of what was the inspiration behind writing this book and what kind of impact are you trying to create?
Thank you very much, Rohel. And thanks to all panelists, our good friends and colleagues in the media. That's why you introduced already them. You know, everybody nowadays talk about the challenges. Now we are facing more problems. The media is in struggling, but I think Sachinanda Murthy ji, and he also did with the Malayala Manorama. We know since last 50-60 years, or even one can say 75 years, our senior colleagues from Maman Mathew ji also wrote about it. And number of editors, as Nihal Singh, Kuldeep Nayar, always remember those editors. In Hindi, Rajen Mathur, Manohar Shyam Joshi, my colleague in Outlook, my colleague is my senior colleague, Vinod Mehta, writer. So everybody was asking, this is the more challenges nowadays in this book, and especially the new generation who are in the media, including Rubika. I still feel when she spent so many years in media, but even then I feel she also asked, what is the problem? What is happening? People, why so much people are asking that now we have more threats? So I thought, and our publisher Bloomsbury, Praveen Tiwari is editor. So he suggested me, why don't you write your experience? Because I worked with the agency Hindustan Samachar 71. Even before that, 1 year I was in Nigeria, Indore. 5 years I spent in agency, then the weekly Saptahik Hindustan, Hindustan Times Group. Spent some time in the Germany, 3 years, Voice of Germany. Then came back in Times Group. Vidman, Navbharat Times, then Hindustan, Askar, Outlook. So I worked so many newspapers. Then now launched Nayi Duniya, Outlook Hindi also launched. So I had different kind of experience and know how editors, and with the Editors Guild. Mr. Murthy was our Secretary General and he always helped. And he is a pioneer in this field also. He helped to for code of ethics also. And the question of paid news. So that's why we thought that we should write and contribute for the next generation and even present colleagues also, that our former editors, they also face a lot of challenges. I interviewed them number of times on the television or for the magazine, for the newspapers. So I thought we should share these points of view with large number of Indian readers and even outside also. That's why the Bloomsbury is an international publisher. They have headquartered in the United Kingdom. And that's why I'm also thankful. I would like to mention Kailash Satyarthi ji are from Nobel laureate. Then Raman Jeffrey, I think everybody knows, he's a very journalism scholar. He also read the whole book manuscript and then commented. Aman Matthew ji was very kind enough because he was also president of the Editors Guild. We worked together as general secretary. Then I was president because of him and other colleagues. Then British High Commissioner earlier, former Zamar, he also read the book and he also commented about it. So because I wanted that the friends can praise it, but the real objective is people should know that in international era also, people are talking about the Indian journalism and present context. So I think we will discuss more. I will not speak much, but I am very thankful to Exchange for Media, Anurag Bhatraji, because he also commented. That's why I mentioned to him, because I mentioned everybody. But Anurag Bhatraji, from the very beginning, and I have always called him a media mogul. He is not Robert Murdoch, but I wish that one day he will, because he has good contact with everybody. And that's why he devoted so much for media. So I feel, and he also commented about how it will be helpful for the mass communication institutions and new generation of the media. So
thank you very much. I want to talk to you, Mr. Murthy, at this point. Having read this book, what kind of issues does it touch upon and the solution it offers? What is your reading of, how do you read this entire, how do you sum it up, the entire book, in your words?
One of the great things about this book for me is I also started my journey just before the emergency, journalistic journey. So when I read the entire book, I thought, okay, I'm on a very familiar road. I've traveled on this road. But then I'm also going with a very experienced guide. That is Alok Mehta. That is, he's showing me newer sides on a very familiar route of journalism where I've seen the kind of changes which happened. As he rightly notes in the book, the two big impactful events of our society. Our society itself has been going through a huge churn. The India which we knew every decade changes in the next decade. So in that, the media has changed. And Alok ji has held a mirror to that whole changing world. First was the impact of the emergency, the kind of thing. Suddenly we realized that freedom is very valuable. Then the economic reforms, which made us realize money is very valuable in the media, money and power. So, and Alok ji holds a mirror to whatever has happened across. Like him, I've also seen the media, interplay of media, power, and politics at the state level as well as the national level. So, I mean, this book is a true reflection of what has happened over the last, and how different kind of editors have come up, how they have changed, and also the different kind of managements. I mean, we are now today talking about startups, unicorns, somebody coming from nowhere and all that. But you look at the history of the media in the country in the last 60 years, very unlikely barons have come from very unlikely fields. People who are either in the newspaper hawkers or who are in rice business. All of us know about it. So the kind of publishers, the kind of editors who have come. So Alok ji has looked at all these things, and then he has looked at two models of journalism. But I'd like to say that there are other models which they don't emphasize, because again, they look more at the English press. But then the regional press has, by and large, has a different model from either the Times of India model or the Indian Express model, which he has emphasized in the book. So that way, this is a journey for me. And I really, because the last powerful book of an editor in India, I remember long ago in my younger days, I read was D.R. Mankekar's book of anguish. He titled it as "Know My Son Never." That is, he was telling his son, please don't become a journalist. Don't become an editor. Don't enter journalism. It was a sort of very, very dire warning that this is a very toxic profession. And this was written in the 60s, if I remember. So, but then after that, the kind of changes which have happened, and Alok ji brings in the entire history of Indian media for the last 60 years. So it's an amazing journey, and I was very impressed by it.
Thanks. Now to the only lady on the panel, Rupika ji, your initial thoughts on this book. What kind of reading, what is the takeaway for you from this book?
First of all, namaste, adab to all the dignitaries present here. Padma Shri Alok Mehta ji is here, and I respect him a lot. And but ye hai ki wo bahut kadavar tarike se apni baat rakhte hain, and he's not scared of anything when he knows that he's standing by the truth and with the truth. So this book is all about it, his experience. So look, if I stand in front of Alok ji, so I am just a tiny bit. So when I was reading this book, and when I was going through these chapters and pages, like Mr. Murthy said, that aisa lag raha tha jaise ye jani pehchani jagah hai. Par mere liye pata hai kya tha, mere liye aisa tha ki main us jagah par hu jahan ek bahut badi building ban gayi hai. और आलोक जी बता रहे हैं कि तुम्हें पता है पहले यहाँ पर पहाड़ हुआ करते थे, पहले यहाँ पर इस तरीके से मैदान हुआ करता था, एंड व्हाट आई सी इज अ ह्यूज इनॉर्मस बिल्डिंग. सो बट आई एम स्टैंडिंग राइट देयर, थिंग्स आर ऑलमोस्ट, वहां पहले घर हुआ करता था, अभी भी शायद घर ही है, लेकिन चीजें कैसे बदल गई हैं. सो आलोक जी इस बुक इज टेकिंग मी बैक इन हिज मेमोरी लेन. And आज की perspective से if I read this book, कई चीजें बहुत similar है जो कभी नहीं बदलेंगी. We really wish, we hope कि चीजें बदल जाए, पर नहीं बदलेंगी. अब होता ये है कि जैसा कई बार इन किताबों के अलग अलग chapters और lessons में आया है, that कहाँ pressure डालने की कोशिश की गई और कैसे उस pressure से निकला गया है. प्रेशर हमेशा एक ही तरफ से नहीं आया, लाइक मिस्टर मूर्ति सेड दैट अनलाइकली प्रेशर फ्रॉम अनलाइकली प्लेसेस, अनलाइकली पीपल. यू नो प्रेशर कई बार आज की तारीख में, इफ आई ट्राई टू पुट इट इन स्ट्रेट वर्ड्स, सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट पब्लिक हियर हु हैज चोजन अ गवर्नमेंट फॉर 5 years गेट्स अटैच्ड टू दैट. यू नो पहले ऐसा होता था कि आपने 5 साल सेलेक्ट कर दिया, इलेक्ट कर दिया गवर्नमेंट को, एंड यू वॉचिंग देम वर्क. इफ दे डोंट, यू विल यू नो इलेक्ट देम, इलेक्ट अ न्यू गवर्नमेंट. बट राइट नाउ व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज दैट एवरी सिंगल पर्सन हु इज ऑन सोशल मीडिया, ऐसा लगता है कि वो आइडियोलॉजिकली इतना अटैच हो गया है, चाहे वो गवर्नमेंट हो, चाहे वो विपक्ष का पक्ष हो, दे आर ऑल अटैच्ड विद ईच अदर. और instead of seeing them how they are working, these election mein shamil hone wale tamam voters, aisa kai baar lagta hai khas kar social media par ki they are working, ki khabardar aapne inse sawal pucha, khabardar aapne inke bare mein kuch kaha, aur ye dono taraf se ho raha hai. So you know, like aapne power, press and politics, mujhe lagta hai isme ek public bhi attach kar dena chahiye tha. क्योंकि अब हम सब सोशल मीडिया के आने के बाद से दिस बिकम्स द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग. आलोक जी वैसे शानदार है पावर, प्रेस एंड पॉलिटिक्स, पर आजकल आप देख रहे हैं ना सोशल मीडिया की वजह से पब्लिक का इन्फ्लुएंस भी बहुत स्ट्रांग हो गया है. लेकिन इस किताब को जब आप पढ़ेंगे तब आप पुराने टाइम में जाएंगे, बड़ा आनंद आपको आएगा. एंड आनंद खुद यहाँ पर इनफैक्ट मौजूद है, और आनंद इसलिए आएगा क्योंकि किस्सा वो ही है कि वो आते हैं, फिर वो ये कहते हैं, देन ही सिट्स डाउन, फिर वो ये सोचते हैं, ऐसा लगता है जैसे आपके सामने पूरी मूवी चल रही है. एंड आई एम श्योर पीपल आर गोइंग टू एंजॉय विद फैक्ट्स एंड द एनेक्डोट्स.
राइट, तो आनंद जी के पास ही जाते हैं हम. मिस्टर दशमिन, सो पावर, पॉलिटिक्स एंड प्रेस, अ हेडी कॉकटेल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, your takeaways from this book, and do you think this still exists, you know, the title that it captures the reality of journalism, does it still exist in that fashion?
Well, namaste to everybody, and I'm very, very humbled and honored. I have immense respect for Satchidananda Murthy, Alok Mehta ji, a very, very senior journalist, and Dr. Anurag Patra is somebody who would identify that how much the editorial bent of his mind or his head has to balance it with the business end. And the talk about the golden ratio, the talk about finding that balance where you're able to do what is in the good of the public, balance that with your own convictions and what you need to do. And add to that this reality, ये बात हमको समझने की जरूरत है कि दुनिया में कोई भी मीडिया इंडिपेंडेंट नहीं, और ये दुनिया में कोई भी मीडिया इंडिपेंडेंट तब तक नहीं होगा जब तक कि आपकी डिपेंडेंसी इस बात पे होगी कि आप एक कॉस्ट सेंटर हैं और आपको कमाना है, और जब तक आपको कमाना है तब तक आपको इसको बिजनेस की तरह देखना पड़ेगा. आप इसको उस आइडियोलॉजिकल यूटोपियन आइडियोलॉजी की तरह नहीं देख सकते कि मैं वो जर्नलिस्टिक आइडियोलॉजी जो हम जर्नलिज्म स्कूल्स में पढ़ाते हैं उसको हम इम्प्लीमेंट करें. पर ये ग्रेडियंट कितना है इसको समझने की जरूरत है. 4% से लेकर 20-25% जो स्फीयर ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंस होता है, तो जितना कम इन्फ्लुएंस होगा बाहर से, और जितना कम इन्फ्लुएंस होगा उतना आपको आपका चेहरा जो है वो इंडिपेंडेंट लगेगा. पर आज की तारीख में इंडिपेंडेंट के मायने भी बदल गए. मैं आपको सच कहूंगा तो जो आलोक जी की किताब है वो मेरे ऑफिस में पड़ी है, तो जब जब मुझे समय मिलता है मैं वहां पढ़ता हूँ, तो किताब वहां रखी है. आई बीन ऑन द रोड, तो मैं बस अभी कल शाम को ही घर लौटा हूँ और फिर आज मैं घर से जुड़ रहा हूँ, तो इसलिए किताब की कॉपी मेरे पास नहीं, और मैंने पूरी नहीं पढ़ी, पर वहां तक पढ़ी है जो आपके जो 50 साल के जो रिच एक्सपीरियंस है उसके जो पहले 20 साल है वहां तक मैं धीरे धीरे पहुंचा हूँ, क्योंकि मामुन मैथ्यू जी के फॉरवर्ड से लेकर आपकी शुरुआत में ही इतना कुछ है कि उसको पढ़ने में मजा आ रहा है. और सबसे बड़ी बात, एंड व्हिच आई वुड से दैट यू हैव नेम्ड दोस 27 जर्नलिस्ट हु स्टूड अप ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ द इमरजेंसी. उन 27 लोगों का नाम जो किसी भी जर्नलिज्म स्कूल में नहीं पढ़ाया जाता, उन 27 लोगों के बारे में उनकी पोजीशन क्या थी और उनका क्या हश्र हुआ किसी जर्नलिज्म स्कूल में नहीं पढ़ाया जाता. फिरोज गांधी साहब के बारे में जो आपने लिखा है वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है लोगों को समझने के लिए, और जो आपको झेलना पड़ा पटना में क्योंकि आप फॉर्डर्स कैंप के पीछे लगे थे और आपने उसके बारे में कहना शुरू किया, और जिस तरह से आपके पीछे लगे थे वो भी देखने की जरूरत है कि जो अपने आप को डेमोक्रेसी का परचम लहराने वाले और डेमोक्रेसी को बचाने की बात करते हैं वो किस तरह से इन्फ्लुएंस करते हैं. कई चीजें हैं, जब मैं जनरल न्यूज में नहीं था, स्पोर्ट्स जर्नलिस्ट था, तो मैंने भी बहुत प्रत्यक्ष देखा है इतना इन्फ्लुएंस होता है, कितना कहा जाता है. तो ये इंडिपेंडेंस की बात तो कहीं थी नहीं, और प्रेस हमेशा प्रेस होती थी पॉलिटिक्स और पावर की वजह से, और इसमें अपना जरिया निकालना ये एक अलग चैलेंज है. इट्स अ डिफरेंट चैलेंज ऑन इट्स ओन. एंड द बिगेस्ट थिंग आलोक जी, एंड आई थिंक दैट इज समथिंग व्हिच वी डोंट रियलाइज, दैट इन द पास्ट व्हाट वाज कंसिडर्ड टू बी द जर्नलिस्ट एलीट एंड आल्सो द रीडिंग एलीट, द थिंकिंग एलीट वाज ओनली 0.1%. द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ दिस कंट्री वाज ऑलवेज एड्रेस्ड इन अ डिफरेंट वे, एंड दैट डोमिनेशन व्हिच हैपेंड, दैट कंट्रोल व्हिच वाज एक्सरसाइज्ड इन द रीजनल मीडिया is a different story altogether. और ये जो प्रताड़ना जर्नलिस्ट को झेलनी पड़ रही है वो तो आजादी से पहले से चल रहा है. बाल गंगाधर तिलक जी हैं, उनका प्रेस था, केसरी जो था उसको किस तरह से प्रताड़ित किया गया, what happened there. In every part of our country we've had to see that those who sit in power want to call the shots. But the other aspect today is
right.
The other aspect today, and I'm just going to I'll pause after that, is that you are now being called out for having your own idea of presenting or your perspective. तथ्य है आपके सामने, उसको एक चक्षु से ही देखा जाए और एक चक्षु से प्रेजेंट किया जाए तो आप इंडिपेंडेंट है. बट इफ यू प्रेजेंट अनदर परस्पेक्टिव टू दैट एंड अनदर लॉजिकल रैशनल रीजनिंग टू दैट, देन यू आर सडनली बायस्ड एंड यू आर नॉट एन इंडिपेंडेंट थिंकर. दिस आई फील इज रॉन्ग. बट गिवन सोशल मीडिया टूडे, गिवन द एम्बिट एंड द ग्रोथ ऑफ न्यू मीडिया टूडे, I think everybody has a space. So we've got to decide whether we want to see obstacles like a dam, or you've got to behave like a river, which jahan pe where it is, where it finds an obstacle, it finds a way out and continues to flow. So I think that essence comes across, that you find that balance and also find a way to go ahead and muscle on and back your conviction, back what you believe in. And that is something which is my takeout from the book, what I've read so far. कि अगर आपको belief है आपके आप जिस सोच पे कर रहे हैं जिस story पे आप कर रहे हैं no matter what go ahead and put it out because people will appreciate that and people will respect you for that.
Right. Thank you, Mr. Narasimhan, for sharing these thoughts. Dr. Batra, to you, how do you sum up what Sri Mehta Ji has written in his book? What are your takeaways?
Thank you so much, Rohil. First of all, congratulations to Sri Alok Mehta Ji for getting this book published. It's an important milestone in the chronicling of Indian media by people who've been leading the journey or being key part of the journey. I also had the good fortune of reading the manuscript before it got published and have read it after the book has come out. And Anand is the first person to say that I have brain. So thank you, Anand, for acknowledging that I have a brain. I'm not sure, so balance comes later, but on a very serious note, when I read the book for the first time, even in the acknowledgement, I consider that I know a lot about media. I'm a student of media. And when I read the acknowledgements in the book, there were at least 6 people that I didn't know of. I mean, I knew of majority of them. He thanked about 36, 37 people in that acknowledgement. And I knew 30 and I didn't know 6. So point I'm trying to make is, by reading this book, somebody who's deeply interested in media, who's deeply interested in politics, who's deeply interested in governance and is also interested in how somebody like Sri Alok Mehta over the last 5 decades has kept his balance going. And I, he says what he has to say. As Rupika said, bebaak ho karke bolte hai. But phir bhi usme ek shalinta hoti hai, ek balance hota hai, ek lehza aasa hota hai ki it is not offensive. And in his personal life and professional life, he's exactly like that. So I'd like to say that it's an important landmark. As Warren Christopher said, without a free and independent media, true democracy is unattainable. Anand just said that, the notion of free media is relative. I mean, he didn't say it exactly like this, but it means different things to different people. And of course, the background today, Prishthbhumi badal gayi hai. The background is a little different. So it's a book that was needed. The chapters in itself are about very interesting people. He talks about the pressures and the politics and the wealth. He talks about the mirror to political power. He talks about paid news and tells that it is not a new phenomena. It has existed for many, many years. So it's not something that has just come in the last 1 decade. He talks about investigative journalism and sting operations. He talks about what are the new threats to media and what are the trend versus the editor. He talks about political and economic pressure. Political pressure manifests in terms of an economic pressure. Mr. Sachidananda Murthy would know that, sometimes the excess is cut off, the advertising is cut off, and that can create its own pressure. How media is on the receiving end of attacks from everyone. The chapter on that. And of course, how media impacts judiciary and how judiciary impacts media. There's a chapter on that. So it's a book that everyone in the journalism schools, media institutes, universities, media planners, and Mr. Anand Narasimhan was a media planner before he became a journalist, should read, people in the COPCOM, because, it gives a historical perspective, it chronicles. And there couldn't have been anybody better than Padmashri Alok Mehta Ji to write it. So I am happy that this book raises a lot of questions when you read it. Hopefully, it answers some of those questions and it takes you through a journey which gives you a historical perspective. I think much more should be written about Indian media owners, Indian media editorial professional, editorial leaders. I think we need much more material literature, and I'm glad that Sri Alok Mehta is added to it. So congratulations. And
absolutely.
We have a better panel than Mr. Murthy, Ms. Liaquat, and Mr. Narasimhan to be here at the book launch. So I'm glad that we're doing it one day before the Independence Day, and I'm sure this book will go on to become a reference point for a lot of people who want to look at the history of media over the last 4 to 5 decades.
Absolutely, absolutely. And what a way, I mean, what a day we have
to... Rohail, that power, press and politics is a heady cocktail. It is. It exists today also, right? And right. There has to be a healthy interaction, but sometimes this healthy interaction can become unhealthy in more ways than one. It can become unhealthy because it can be lopsided. Right. And, you know, I remember about our news broadcast awards is 14 years young, but in the third or fourth, I'm not sure, it was at the Oberoi Delhi, and I'd invited Riz Khan because I'm a very big news aficionado. I watch 3 hours of news even today. But there was a time I used to watch 5-7 hours of news. So I used to watch a lot of CNN, which I still do, and I watch all the Indian channels, of course, one or two on my home, you know, like my home page. But I'd invited Riz Khan because when I was growing up, Riz Khan was this tall news anchor on, not literally tall, he's very tall, he's 6 foot, but he was really tall. And I invited him when I started doing this. And there was a debate that he had with a leading Indian anchor and about should the anchor be presenting his or her point of view? This was almost 10 or 11 years back. You know, Riz shared that when he was at CNN, they would only articulate the issue and they'd give both sides. But he also acknowledged the fact that times have changed. In the times where media is itself under attack, journalists, and we are at the receiving end of fake news. We don't create fake news. Maybe a small section does, but fake news is created by political parties. It's created by vested interests. It's created by groups that want to spread a certain kind of message. We are at the receiving end of it. We are not creating it, except in some splinter cases. But today, in India, media groups have an ideology. People understand who has which ideology. Anchors have an ideology. And, you know, it's a gray area. We can keep debating. You should present both sides. But in a point where the viewer or the reader looks at the anchor to be able to decipher the world for them, to be able to give their point of view, I think that perspective is also interesting. So, you know, it's not an either-or case. I just want to say that today also this heady cocktail of power, press, and politics exists. It's just the nature is a little different than
absolutely. So true, and what a day we have chosen. I mean, tomorrow is the Independence Day, and we are discussing something which is of such a great significance. Mr. Mehta, tell me, while you were writing the book, you've captured so much in these pages. How do you, if I ask you, which is your favorite chapter, for example? Give me is there one chapter that's your favorite one? Take me through the process of while you were writing the book. How did you decide? Was it tough what to write? Kya itna bebaak hona hai? Do you want to be this much candid? You know, what all was going in your mind while you were writing this book?
The number of issues because of the political and economic power. People think that now the corporate, Anand Narasimhan also mentioned it, now he's working with the TVT and the guys also there. Two contrasts. Malayalam Manorama, now they also have the television network, but communists also targeted Malayalam Manorama. Paman Nehruji several times mentioned about it. Or even the Congress. Sometimes they also use, no, they are biased. Same in the economic forces, the Tatas were there, which I mentioned in the book. The statesmen, those days, Mr. Sahai, he was also very senior in our HS Guild. And legal issues, he was there 30 years. So he, and I think his memoir also, he mentioned that how the Tata, even Kuldeep Nair also mentioned about it. Tata were also there in the statesman time. Our Birlas and Goenka are Dalmias, you know. And most of them, I work with the Birlas and Times Group now. I didn't work with the Goenka group, the Nexus group. So that's why I wanted to say that the pressure always with the editors. Manoj Shyam Joshi, famous name in Hindi media or English also. He launched first tabloid newspaper Morning Echo. But in one day, when the Janata Party, after emergency, because of the pressure of the Kranti Desai, there was one good column story. It was not even the article commented by editors. Said he should be sacked today itself. and the whole day, how do we spend? Advani ji and Bahura and others, they helped us to save him. Rajesh Mathur also suffered different kind of pressure. Kamleshwar was very famous writer. He was sacked and even cabin was locked. Earlier also the management, they used to do, not because of the political power, even the Mrs. Gandhi, when he wrote a Gandhi film. And then Mrs. Gandhi came in power and he became the additional director general of Doordarshan. So, you know, you have to face the challenges. And that's why I'm giving one example. What I mentioned, even the terrible story, the clippings of Chandra Swami. He was very, at that time, used to stay in guest house of the Times Globe and all. When I was not even a writer, I wrote about him. Nobody objected. Rajesh Mathur allowed me to write about it. Even I was in Hindustan, that time he was very powerful. Narsimha Rao ji was the Prime Minister. He was very close to Prime Minister. But I wrote about Chandra Swami. Nobody objected. Not the Birlas, not Shobhna Bhartia, Rao. Even Rao, Narsimha Rao, he was so kind. He awarded me. I wrote a book, Who After Rao? Rao ke baad kaun in Hindi. But he never objected. He just said, Paniri Paniri said, Kare, aapke mitro ko kya jaldi hai? Uspe I mentioned the Madhav Rao Sindhya, then Rajesh Pailet, Sharad Pawar also. But I was not paid through Sharad Pawar, but even then I met Atal Bihari Vajpayee too. I said, ki, sir, Rao sahab, yehi ki ye log bhi aapke saath ke team ke hain, kabhi ban sakte hain. So what I say, ki, in every prime minister, they have their own. Present Prime Minister also, people talk about it. Depend, not because the Modi ji is here, to regularly read the week. Very objective kind of journalism. Na? Sometimes you criticize, but you not criticize a person, not criticize the system. But critical about the problems, about the issues, challenges. But now, what is happening? Either you are with the ruling party, that's why I mentioned about the paid news also. At that time, even the national newspapers, Hindi newspapers, the bureau chief, he used to ask money for publishing for Indira Gandhi ki lehar hogi. I mentioned, Srikant Verma was my friend, he was a journalist also. That's why one can be a Godi media or the Indira media or Congress media or left media. Depends how you see it and how you can fight with the system and survive itself. Maybe you have to change the number of writers, they resign. Rajesh Mathur died because of the pressure from the
government
and the political system also.
Right. Mr. Murthy, which is your favorite chapter in the book and why?
Okay. I would like to look at two chapters together because they both are somewhere related to each other. One is a Chapter 8 on the historical role of the Editors Guild, because Alok ji was its Secretary General for 6 years, President for 2 years, and I was his Secretary General when he was the President. So we have been involved, I think, on the journey of the Editors Guild, Alok ji from the early 80s, me from the 90s. Then the second is Chapter 11, The New Threats and Trends versus the Editor. So, but basically, Alok ji, I want to tell one thing. One of his biggest contribution for press freedom, I don't know how many people know about it, when he was the president of the Editors Guild, the biggest legislative threat of the 21st century to Indian media came in the form of the Broadcast Regulatory Authority of India Bill, which was moved by the UPA government, under Priyaranjan Das Munshi as the Minister for INB. I mean, it was a piece of legislation which set up a BRAI worse than what the IT rules now media is agitated about, which would have allowed a police officer to enter any television studio, seize the equipment, seize the notes, do everything. And it gave all powers to the bureaucracy to control Indian broadcast media, television media, essentially. And so Alok ji was upset by this. He said, what do we do about it? So we both consulted senior editors and others. So Alok ji, who knew the ways of the media as well as the powers, he said, Sachi ji, we have to do a guerrilla tactic attack on this. So I said, what do you mean? I thought we'll hold a big discussion, go and tell the Prime Minister and others. He said, no, because he said most of the television owners will not stand up to the government because they have their own reasons. So they won't come and support. It's not like the anti-defamation agitation of the 1980s against the Rajiv Gandhi government. So he said, let's do something because the minister said he's calling a meeting of the stakeholders in Hotel Samrat of Delhi, I remember. So Alokji was traveling. So he said, what do we do? I said, one thing we can do is we can prepare a very strong criticism of this bill and put it into the public domain. So we requested the major newspapers because no channel was prepared to carry this thing because it was an attack on the government and they were dependent on various. So finally, the Hindu carried the full text. So did Hindustan Times and other papers. So the evening at Samrat was the meeting. I was representing the guild. So when Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, the chairperson, and Manmohan Singh, the prime minister, read the guild statement, they were really taken aback. Is this a vehemence of the editors' guild against this bill? So they called Priranjan Das Munshi and told him. So I was at that meeting. Alokji could not come. He was outside Delhi. And I found that Priranjan Das Munshi was right in the face. He was shouting. And he said, who's there from the editors' guild? So from the back, I raised my hand. I'm here. So you're the guy who has done the mischief. So I'm hereby announcing that news media will not be part of this bill. So which was a very important concession he gave. But I found the big barons of Indian television sitting in the front row were very deferentially speaking. So that is where Alokji's leadership mattered. And I'm happy to say that in the last 15 years, that bill has remained in the cold storage. It has not come through. So, of course, I also provoked the minister by saying that the ministry was working with an NGO mafia. So they had gathered a lot of NGOs. They attacked the Editors Guild. But Alokji and I said, no, we'll stand by this because this is something which is important for press freedom. So I'm just telling you about his commitment to press freedom and ethical values. So when these two chapters on the editors, because the editors now, there are new threats and things. I was told a publisher, director asked a editor, so how will you manage MIS in a meeting? So the editor was taken aback. What MIS? Oh, don't you know about MIS? MIS is Management Information System. So how do you keep the target reader, circulation figure, target? How will you convert each journalist into a profit center? I mean, this is the kind of extremism maybe, but right. These are the kind of challenges and threats which come to the editors.
Right.
So then they don't like IM. This fellow told the editor, see, this institutional memory business, I don't like. Oh, we had this big success. We had this big failure. 20 years ago, we did it. I don't want all that. Now look at the future. So this kind of more and more modern managements where profit and influence and numbers matter. So editors will have to integrate all that and have to function. This happens in some publications and channels. Alokji has written elaborately on the kind of pernicious thing on TRP ratings, which the press council took up. I had edited a committee on private treaties about which he has referred in this book. So the editors of the coming days will be more and more challenges and more thing. But then how they stand up, it depends on the caliber of each one of them. So I am very grateful
to Alokji
highlighting the role of the editor because, you know, last 80 years, as he said, people have lamented that the editor has become unnecessary. A newspaper had once advertised journalists need not apply for the post of reporters. But now that same newspaper wants the best journalists because it realizes that for profits, numbers, eyeballs, they need good journalists. So they are both good.
I think the need for both. Absolutely, absolutely. I think the need for course correction today is so important, like never before. I want to move to Ms. Liaquat. You know, this book raises a lot of issues, credibility and, journalists, you know, being not taking stand, you know, being true to what they do. But, you know, in today's context, I mean, if we look at especially news presenters, you know, very well-known faces like you are here and Ms. Narasimhan is here, you know, you're often, when you are, you're trolled, a lot of criticism is thrown at you. First of all, how justified are people in raising such points? What do you like to tell them, you know, because the book raises these points and I'm just reflecting it, since you are practicing it and you often face this criticism because you are the public figures, you know, both of you. So how do you face this criticism when people talk about credibility and taking, you know, stand, you know, and not being neutral? How do you respond to your critics? Sorry, it's muted.
Okay, can you hear me? Am I audible? So I'm going to connect it with the book. There is a chapter called Love-Hate Relationship. Panchwe number ka ye chapter hai.
Yes.
20 pages mein Alok ji ne puri journey bata di hai ke kisi editor ka, kisi senior correspondent ka, ya kisi resident editor ka, kisi politician se kis tarike ka rishta raha hai. Aur itna ठोस रिश्ता रहने के बावजूद उन्होंने उनके खिलाफ खबरें छापी हैं और फोन आए हैं उनको. फिर उस वक्त तो फोन ज्यादा किए जाते थे, फोन कर करके उनको सुनाया गया है कि कैसे तुम अपने अखबार में ये छाप सकते हो या कैसे तुम अपने कॉलम में ये लिख सकते हो और उसको फिर कैसे डील किया गया. I'll just tell you one thing. Anand was also in Kashmir. I was there in Kashmir. I met a very senior police officer. Met many, but one of them, aaj bhi unka ye kehna hai ki journalist kisi ke nahi hote. And this is the fact. Journalist kisi ke nahi hote. Wo kisi neta ke dost nahi hote hain. Wo kisi businessman ke dost nahi hote hain. Unki dosti ye jo aap kehte na eyeball, व्यूअर्स और इनसे होती है. हमारी दोस्ती इनसे है. ये हमारे माई बाप, सच कहूं तो. और सब ये कहते हैं कि टीआरपी का खेल है, व्यूअर्स का खेल है, लेकिन कोई ये नहीं देखता है कि वो जो आई बॉल है वो किसकी है. क्या मैं जबरदस्ती उन आई बॉल्स को मेरे टीवी को देखने को मजबूर कर सकती हूँ? क्या मैं उनको हिप्नोटाइज कर सकती हूँ? सो इट इज अ टू वे रिलेशनशिप. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट हर सिक्के के दो पहलू होते हैं और जैसा डॉक्टर बत्रा कह रहे थे कि एक बैलेंस मेंटेन करके चलना होता है. अब मुझे ये बताइए आप, और मैं हर बार ये बात कहती हूँ कि जब कश्मीर में एक आतंकवादी मारा जा रहा है तो मैं इसमें बैलेंस कहाँ से लाऊं भाई? जब एक आतंकवादी कहीं घुसकर आपके सिटी में अटैक कर रहा है तो मैं इसमें बैलेंस कहाँ से लाऊं? उस आतंकवादी को आतंकवादी ना बोल के मैं क्या दहशतगर्द हूँ? मैं उसे मिलिटेंट हूँ. जो सच है वो तो मुझे कहना पड़ेगा ना. इसमें कहां से मैं बीच की लाएंगे? सो और कई बार ये कहा जाता है कि एंकर जो प्रेजेंटर है वो कैसे अपना आइडिया जो है थोप सकते हैं. आनंद वुड नो दिस नाउ. तो अनुराग बत्रा आल्सो इज अ होस्ट, सो ही आल्सो नोज इट. हम जाकर बस अपनी बातें ऐसे नहीं कह देते. हमारे पीछे पूरी टीम है, एक पूरी लाइन और लेंथ होती है. हमारा पूरा ग्रुप रूबिका लियाकत के जो बस में आएगा वो नहीं कर देगी. मुझे पता है कि हमारी एक रूल बुक है, मेरी कंपनी जो है उसके स्टैंडर्ड्स हैं, उसके 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 अपने प्रिंसिपल्स हैं. मेरी टीम में मेरे एडिटर्स होते हैं, मेरे प्रोड्यूसर होते हैं, बाकी इनफैक्ट जो इंटर्न्स होते हैं उनके अपने आइडियाज होते हैं. वी ऑल सिट टुगेदर और इसमें हम लोग इस बात को लेकर चर्चा करते हैं. वी हैव डिस्कशन. And that is when the anchor goes and says that, and why can't an anchor, so how do I debate? I'll tell you one thing. For example, Mr. Murthy, Mr. Mehta, Mr. Narasimhan, and Mr. Batra are on the panel. Okay. Ab isme kahan se biasness hogi? Bhai, maine keh diya ke Alok ji, let's debate. Debate kya hai? Main kehti hu Alok ji ki ye kitab hit hai. Maine line le li. मैं कंक्लूजन पर पहुंच गई. अब मैं पीछे की तरफ आ रही हूं कि मिस्टर नरसिम्हन प्रूव मी दैट आई एम रॉन्ग दैट दिस बुक इज नॉट अ हिट. आई एम डिबेटिंग इफ ही डजंट लाइक द बुक he has all the rights to say it on my program. Hunkar mein wo hunkar bhar sakte hain. Agar main Mr. Narasimhan ko nahi bula rahi hu ya Mr. Murthy ko nahi bula rahi hu, tab aap keh sakte hain ki ye bias. So iske piche ek thought process nahi hota. What happens is we the people from media become the punching bag. भाई यहाँ से भी काम नहीं हो रहा है, यहाँ से भी काम नहीं हो रहा है, तो क्या किया जाए? आपने क्या किया? इट्स सो इजी रोहेल कि आपने ये फोन उठाया अपना और इस फोन पर आपने चार लाइनें लिख दी. आपने ये नहीं सोचा कि इसके पीछे की मेहनत क्या है, इसके पीछे की सोच क्या है, किस तरीके से इस पूरे प्रोग्राम को बनाया गया है. नहीं, इफ यू बिलोंग टू ए पर्टिकुलर पार्टी और मान लीजिए वहां उस पार्टी की सरकार नहीं है तो वो ये कहेंगे देखिए ये बायस है. अगले दिन वही सवाल अगर मैं दूसरी पार्टी से कहूंगी तो वो कहेंगे देखिए आप बायस्ड हैं. दोनों तरफ से बेसिकली सैंडविच में टमाटर है इस वक्त मीडिया, टमेटो जिसे आप कहते हैं, वो यहां से भी प्रेस होगा. जैसे आनंद कह रहे थे कि वो प्रेस बेचारा प्रेस ही हो रहा है, बट दैट विल नॉट स्टॉप अस. एक कन्विक्शन होना और लोगों के लिए क्या सही होना, ये दोनों जब साथ चलेंगे ना तो वो एरिस्टोटल का जो कहना था, हालांकि वो जर्नलिस्ट नहीं थे लेकिन उनका जो कहना था वो सही मायने में आ जाएगा. अगर आप में कन्विक्शन और आप जानते हैं कि ये लोगों के लिए सही है, नथिंग विल स्टॉप यू.
राइट मिस्टर नरसिम्हन, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट क्रेडिबिलिटी एंड द वे वी लुक एट इट एंड वी डिबेट अबाउट इट, आर वी टेकिंग अ बैलेंस व्यू और डू यू थिंक वी आर अननेसेसरली बैशिंग मीडिया व्हिच इज कॉट इन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स सिचुएशन?
What is a balanced view?
Like how people say that,
no,
you know,
I'm just saying,
in the media schools, for example,
your sense of balance could vary from my sense of balance, could vary from differ from what Alok Mehta's sense of balance is or what Sachidanand Murthy's sense of balance is. So if I am saying something, you have the freedom to call me out and you have the freedom to try and cancel me. But I don't have the freedom to say it. So how is that balanced? So the point is, yeah, and what am I saying? If the argument is based on a particular logic, is based on fact and a perspective, you have the freedom to agree with that perspective or disagree with that perspective. Now, if you disagree with that perspective, can you abuse your right to freedom by trying to come out and cancel me out? Bhai, ye jo bol raha hai, ye thoda forceful hai. Ye jo bol raha hai, sensible hai. Isko abhi cancel kar do, khatam kar do, nahi to kal ko ye iski baat log, zyada log sunne lag jayenge. So then, you know, the right to freedom of expression stops, you know, your freedom of expression stops where my nose begins. You have to remember that. It comes with reasonable restrictions. The other part is that if we start bothering about the number of people who are trying to troll us or cancel us out, then we will stop doing our work. Like I said, at the beginning, I said, the one inspiration that I draw from people like Sachidanand Murthy ji and also Alok Mehta ji is they have the courage of conviction and also the guts to go ahead and follow through that conviction. We need to have that. If I'm not convinced, if I don't have the conviction on what I'm going to put on show on air, just like Rubika was saying, anybody or what right. they're going to put pen to paper. So if they don't have conviction with their thoughts, if they don't have facts to back their argument, do you think they will write what they will do? Right? Alok Mehta ji or Sachidanand Murthy ji? Or we will say what we have to say on our show? I can't. झूठ के पांव नहीं होते और झूठ के जो झूठ पर अगर आप जो किले बना रहे हैं वो किले फट से गिर जाएंगे. इट इज एट द एंड ऑफ द डे इट इज द ट्रुथ दैट स्टैंड्स एंड दिस इज व्हाट इज इरिटेटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु आर जस्ट ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट नैरेटिव्स एंड व्हेन यू ट्राई टू बस्ट दोस नैरेटिव्स विद फैक्ट्स एंड विद अ रीजनेबल लॉजिकल आर्ग्यूमेंट देन दे कम बैक एंड देन ट्राई एंड स्लैंडर यू पर्सनली. द मोमेंट समबडी गेट्स पर्सनल विद यू, यू हैव एक्चुअली वन द आर्ग्यूमेंट. द मोमेंट देयर इज पीपल हु आर रिएक्टिंग टू व्हाट यू आर राइटिंग or what you are saying on the show, that means you have a certain element of truth with you. And you are going ahead and say, see, you can counter facts with facts, you can counter argument with argument. But if I'm intolerant to your point of view, then how does that make me liberal? If I am intolerant, to what you have to say and not unwilling to listen to you, and I start branding you with a particular name or calling you a dalal or whatever it is, then how are you liberal? And how am I liberal if I'm doing that? So this is what the aspect is. And this kind of political pressure which is being talked about, the influence which is being talked about, I have seen how pyar se kehkar, puchkar ke kehkar, aur daat ke kehkar, it was far greater, far more. I am witness to government ministers in the past calling up the editor-in-chief and dictating the lines which should go on the ticker, on the bottom ticker of the channel, and telling the person what debate you have to do tonight and what is the question that you have to ask. That's the level of influence I have witnessed by those who claim to be the champions of free will and democracy. So the reality is that at all points in time, people who stand there based on the courage of their conviction and argue on facts and call out the right issues will always face pressure. The other aspect is, like I said, and I'm going to just say it again, the pressure on the editor is immense, and it's mentioned in Alokji's book, and Sachidanandaji said is very true, because they have to balance media as a cost center. I'm a media planner. From an advertising agency's point of view, media department was a cost center. In a journal, from a journalism point of view, and from this, we are a cost center, because we are not churning out profits. We are churning out editorial, and we all need to get paid at the end of the day. So for the businessman who's setting up a news channel, that person has to earn from somewhere. And those earnings will be directly influenced by those in power, be it corporates or be it politicians or governments of the day. So in various state governments, there is pressure exerted. You cannot say something against certain chief ministers or certain governments in certain disposition. Why? Because bhai, unke wahan se advertising revenue aa raha hai. चैनल का जो हमारे घर का महीने के एंड की सैलरी जो है वो उनके पैसे से आ रही है, तो आप थोड़ा आराम से बोलिए. तो ये इन्फ्लुएंस नहीं हुआ, ये डेमोक्रेसी है. तो ये तो रियलिटी है. तो लाइक आई सेड दैट ग्रेडिएंट, नो इट्स रिलेटिव, 4% to 25%. सो एज लॉन्ग एज अ मीडिया चैनल और मीडिया ग्रुप इज क्लोजर टू द 4% एंड इट इज इन सिंगल डिजिट्स, यू कैन परसीव इट टू बी लार्जली इंडिपेंडेंट एंड दैट द जर्नलिस्ट विल गेट अ स्पेस. What does digital media do today, or a website or a platform like that do? It allows you to put both points of view. So Sachidanandaji, me, Alokji, you, four of us can pen four different articles on the same issue, and all four perspectives are there for the viewer to read and imbibe. So that's the sense of balance new media is allowing you to create. So if there are forces from here who will try and cancel you out, there are forces from here who support you and stand up in your support. So somewhere there's that, you know, automatically amidst the chaos, there is a balance that's created on a larger scale, if you were to see. And that's what perhaps today new media allows you to do. It allows a Ruhel Amin and Alok Mehta and Anand Narasimhan, a Rubika Liyakat and Anurag Batra and a Sachidanand Murthy also to read everybody, pen their own pieces, put out their perspective on a particular story, and allow the viewer, the consumer, to decide who they want to agree with or disagree with. And I think that perhaps is the better way to look at it. But pressure is always going to be there. I will be marked by those who do not agree with my point of view. You will be marked by those who do not agree with your point of view. And depending upon who has the balance of power in their favor or who's politically stronger, they will try and exercise their influence. What is it that I can do? Can I decide how you should think? No. But can I be conviction? Can I be convinced about how I think and continue to push that? And eventually realize that people will appreciate that where you are coming from is based on just one simple narrative. And that's where I respect Alokji and Sachidananda Murthy ji, that their core part is the goodness of the country. As long as I say what is good for my country and what is not good for my country, and I base my arguments, my stories, my debates, my articles on that and reason, I think the rest will sort itself out in the long run. But we've got to stay steadfast on that binary, that my story is Bharat. My interest is the betterment of Bharat. And for me, my country matters ahead of everything else. And what is good for my country, if somebody is doing even some bit which is good, it's not because I like that person. I just feel that that person has got the interest of the country foremost, ahead of the interest of self, party, you know, community, etc. It's my country that comes first. And as long as that is happening, we'll back those people, or we'll take that position. I think that's something which I really respect Alokji and Sachidananda Murthy ji for that. And that courage of conviction comes from your love for your country. And how clear can you be like that? And then people will realize you may have to change jobs, you may please, but you will always get that space to write that narrative, which is Bharatwadi.
Well, I just wanted one
adding
something to because the regional press, the Indian languages press, they have more challenges, more pressures. Because in sitting in Delhi, you can have more protection, you can reach the government. But there, what Anand mentioned about it, more pressures from Bihar to Kerala, Jammu, Kashmir, or anywhere. Regional leaders,
right,
parties, and the organizations, they
right,
shine more than anybody else. That's why.
Rohit, just give me 30 seconds. Now, I was in Jammu and Kashmir. I spent a lot of time in Jammu, last 15 days. Okay, I've gone there 2-3 times and I've gone to the deepest rural parts of the country and I've met local journalists who are doing work there. You know what they have coming out and saying? Their perspective, they are living in so much fear that they say that I write one line here or there. I say one thing which certain people don't like, they will target my wife, my daughter, my sister, my family. So it's a game of fear which is being played out there, not the game of freedom. And then they are, despite that, they are standing there and then they are penning articles, they're doing stories which talks about the beauty of Jammu and Kashmir, the people of Jammu and Kashmir, and the idea of Bharat, or you know, working with the country, working with the rest of the country. So they're still doing it. And I have immense respect for them. But the fact is that the national media there has let them down by falling to a lexicon and a narrative which is trying to prop up and work as an apologist. A terrorist is a terrorist, my friend. The person who takes, who lobs a grenade, not caring for the fact that a 4-year-old is dying or a 2-year-old is dying and an innocent is dying, that person cannot have any sympathy from anybody because that person doesn't care. And that person is a terrorist. That conviction we need to have. That's where there is going to be courage that will come to talk about the real issues. Over to you.
Right. Perfect. So you know, and I just want to, this chapter 11 in this book, Dr. Batra, to you, which talks about threats and trends versus the editor. So if I talk about the new trends and the new threats in the newsroom, the editorial room, how do you see this, you know?
See, first of all, this debate between Saraswati and Lakshmi, you know, chasing editorial excellence and all the things that Alokji, Mr. Murthy talked about, you have to have. Jahan pe Saraswati ji ka vaas hoga, wahan Lakshmi ji aayi jayegi. So first of all, you have to have viewers. First of all, you have to have readers. First of all, you have to be known for something sharp. And every real editor understands that. And I must say that now I run Business World, but for 14 years I did run E4M. I don't run it anymore. Of course, I editorially, I read it. I have a point of view on it. But I must tell you that we built Exchange for Media by saying what we needed to say. But we don't run Exchange for Media to run down our community. I mean, there are other sites whose agenda is only they do negative stories about what's wrong with media, what's wrong with media people. We're about marketing, advertising, and media. So I think balance is required. Intent matters. And most importantly, at the end of the day, as Rubika said, our loyalties are towards readers. If you don't give good content, you will not have traffic. You will not have editorial impact. Forget. Also, journalists don't just live for money. They live for editorial impact. कि उनकी स्टोरी का कितना इंपैक्ट हुआ, क्या उससे इंपैक्ट हुआ, क्या उसकी चर्चा हुई, क्या उससे कुछ एक्शन हुआ, तो वो तभी होता है जब उसमें कुछ ऑथेंटिसिटी हो, उसमें फैक्चुअलनेस हो और उसमें एक शार्प पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू हो.
राइट.
सो आई वुड से दैट आई थिंक इंडियन मीडिया can do a lot better than it is doing now. But as I said, we are working in a very tough media environment. And let me articulate why it is so tough. When you look at broadcasting, this government has been around only for 7 years. And, you know, for those, all those people who say that this government tries to control the media, all that, all governments do. You know, Mr. Murthy talked about Priyaranjan Nath Munshi, who INV minister there, and I started an exchange for media when he was the INV minister. I remember what you talked about very, very vividly. So, you know, it is nothing new, right? So, aisa nahi ki pehli baar ho raha hai ki yahi sarkar koshish karti hai. To purani sarkare bhi bahut koshish karti thi aur bahut control karti thi. Sabke tarike alag hote hai. Everybody ways and means are different. But today we have social media. We have individuals who are following. So you cannot hide a point of view. It will get accentuated. And let me say to our viewers that there is enough points of view. If there is a certain right-wing leaning media, there is a left-wing leaning media. So, you know, I think if you can choose what you want to read, watch, view. So the choice is yours.
Right.
You know, we can keep debating about it. So that balance is needed. And again, Anand asked this question, ki, aapki balance ki definition kya hai? I mean, according to you, it's balance. According to me, it's not balance. And, you know, by the way, Anand and Rupika, Rohail is Kashmiri. He's right now, he's in Kashmir. And last 3 months, he's been working out of Kashmir. And he is in Kashmir. He understands the situation in Kashmir well. We are planning a J&K media summit also. But coming to his Alok Ji's book, and specifically about Alok Ji, ये आलोक जी का दिन है और उनकी किताब के के संदर्भ में हम सब शामिल हुए हैं. यू नो आलोक जी इज बीन ऑन द इनबा ज्यूरी फॉर लास्ट 10 इयर्स. 10 में से 7-8 ज्यूरीज की होंगी एंड आई थिंक इज द ओनली पर्सन एंड यू नो आई बिकॉज ही ब्रिंग्स बैलेंस. ही मे हैव हिज पर्सनल व्यू ऑन दिस गाय इज बेटर, दिस शो इज बेटर, बट आई हैव सीन हिम इन ज्यूरी डेलिब्रेशन. ही इज ही इज द वॉइस ऑफ रीजन, पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एंड बैलेंस. I think when Mr. Murthy, Mr. Nasiman, Ms. Liaquat, you were approached for being, I called you, you took 1 second to accept it because of his respect or his stature and the fact how he engages with everyone. So I just want to say that I've known Mr. Murthy from the day I started. I remember I meet him when, and I would seek his view more like 17, 18 years back, 15 years back. And again, Mr. Mehta, I met. And I think... you know, you shouldn't have personal animosity with anyone. You can have an acerbic viewpoint also. You can have a sharp viewpoint. But you have to distinguish, as Mr. Mehta said, the issue from the person, the subject from the person. And yes, there is less tolerance. We take criticism personally. It is good and bad if we can use that to change ourselves, if there is a real viewpoint. But I must tell you, sometimes, I'm not referring to anyone on the panel, even the media panel, media profession, journalists, editors, media owners become like politicians. They learn all the bad habits from them. They cannot take a negative story, cannot take a criticism. I don't want to give you the name of an anchor and editor who did not come to Inba this year because some 1.5 years back, Samachar for Media did some story, which I had not heard till the day of the Inba. And he said, main to chota aadmi hu, sir, mujhe bula ke kya karoge aap? Main to bahut chota tu. Maine bula, aap naraaz hai. फिर 10 मिनट बाद मुझे खुले उन्होंने बताया मुझसे क्यों नाराज है. तो मैंने कहा मुझे फोन करते मैं हटवा देता उनके शो के बारे में. उनके पास पर्सनल भी कुछ नहीं था. उनका शो था कि उनका शो अच्छा नहीं है, उनके बारे में कुछ कहा नहीं है, शो अच्छा नहीं है. मैं नाम नहीं ले सकता, बट यू नो तो पॉइंट इज इट टुक मी अ लॉट ऑफ, बिकॉज आई डोंट वांट अ लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट टू काइंड ऑफ गेट इट आउट फ्रॉम हिम, बिकॉज जर्नलिस्ट आर ऑल्सो ह्यूमन बींग, दे हैवंट कम फ्रॉम मार्स वीनस. उनका भी रक्त लाल है हम जैसा, सबके जैसा. तो कोई वो और अजीब प्राणी नहीं है. तो देयर इमोशनल बीइंग, सो आई रिस्पेक्ट दैट, आई सी इट एज पैशन. बट समटाइम्स मीडिया प्रोफेशनल्स टेक ऑल द रॉन्ग लेसंस फ्रॉम पॉलिटिशियंस. वो जैसे उनको ट्रीट करते हैं वो एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं ट्रेड मीडिया भी वैसे ही करे. आई रन अ B2C प्रोडक्ट इन बिजनेस वर्ल्ड. वहां यू नो एडवर्टाइजर्स आर इवन वन लेवल अप, दे कट एडवर्टाइजिंग एंड व्हेन इट फाइनेंशियली हर्ट्स यू, इट हर्ट्स यू मोर, राइट? सो आई हैव जस्ट टू से, in spite of all these tough challenges, I think by and large the Indian media does a very good job. There are areas we must improve, but I'm sure as we go along, ye samudra manthan jari rahega. To main Alok ji ko I would like to congratulate you, mubarakbad dena chahunga, and I'm sure your book will create the right impact at it, at that it is intended to. I genuinely believe that more books on Indian media and Indian media professionals are needed. I conceptualized the book 11 years back, but I haven't written it. But I'm happy my daughter's book is coming out. And I just want to say that in spite of the media people being very kind to me, I've lost it. That's more genetic. It's not because of anyone in the media has been unkind to me. I just want to clarify that. Okay. So back to you, Rohit.
Right. Thank you so much. अब मैं दो एंकर हैं यहाँ पे तो उनसे इंस्पायर होके मैं सबसे एक रिक्वेस्ट करूँगा 30 सेकंड्स के आंसर्स रखें सब. स्टार्टिंग विद यू आलोक जी. सॉरी दिस हैज थ्रोन सो मेनी इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स एंड एवरीवन यू नो हैव एक्सप्रेस्ड योर व्यूज ऑन इट. मैं आपसे ये पूछना चाहूंगा इतने एक्सपीरियंस और इतना सब कुछ देखने के बाद व्हाट इज योर मैसेज to both journalists of today as well as viewers. I think we should not just hold journalists responsible, as Mr. Narasimhan also pointed out. Viewers ke baare mein bhi, what is your message to them?
Everybody think that next generation should come in the journalism or not. But I always say India is such a vast country, big country, that in the rural area, what I think, specialized journalism, like if you are doing something on health, because of the corona, everybody understood how important it is. Education, health, and legal affairs. I think we need a large number of newspapers. Still, there is scope in the rural area, the city newspapers. I think there is scope still. Because the national media, what we call it, we should not think only the Delhi, but I think we should think. And there is a bright future for the Indian journalism. Still, even after the challenges and people think that there is no scope and now the social media is there, but people will read, people will watch,
right.
People will also go on the electronic media or social media. But we will survive. This is the message what I think.
Absolutely. Mr. Bothi.
I agree with Alok ji. You know, finally, the people want more news. And as Anand pointed out, the elite readership percentage, what it was when I or Alok ji came into journalism, what it is. I mean, there's been a huge upward tick in terms of people who are interested in news. They wanted well-presented, well-edited news. Maybe the form of delivery will be different, but news will always thrive and pressure will be there. All I'm saying is that pressure should be like cholesterol. We need good cholesterol, not bad cholesterol. So I think but how do we do the balance? How do we work it out? As Anand pointed out, we have to do that. And Anurag has shown how media watch is also very important. I think he brought in a new element of media watch to this country where I suddenly found that many non-journalistic professionals in newspapers who never read anything would wait for exchange for media to read, devour the news there and then move on to strategize themselves. So I think he has also brought in a lot of Lakshmi to others through exchange for media. Thank you so much.
Right. Great. And I can see Rupika ji having one more speaker with us. Absolutely. your thoughts, Rupika ji, on, the pressure is only on the journalist, the newsroom side, the presenter side. What do you have to tell the viewers, the people who go to Twitter and waste no time in criticizing? Do they also have a responsibility?
Okay, first I have to attend to this gentleman. He is asking me, who is this gentleman here?
Amazing.
I have to tell him, what do you think? He is the gentleman sitting here.
Thank you.
Yeah? He has written this book. Would you read it? Yeah? Okay. Alok sir,
got the right book.
You read it.
हाँ भाई आपके पास सर और वो देखिए इन्होंने तो शुरू कर दिया है. So okay. So I just want to tell these not viewers per se. पता है रोहन मुझे कई बार ये लगता है कि जो मुझे गालियां दे रहे हैं और भद्दी भद्दी बातें मुझे कह रहे हैं उन्होंने मेरा शो देखा ही नहीं है क्योंकि वो क्या करते हैं भाई मान लीजिए रोहेल को मेरा वो सवाल नापसंद आया तो उन्होंने वो हिस्सा काटा मेरे एक घंटे के शो का और उन्होंने उसको वायरल कर दिया पर जो बाकी टाइम बचा था 55 मिनट जो मैंने सवाल पूछे हैं या सुना है वो किसी ने भी नहीं देखा है और उसी पर वो लगातार बार 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 दे गोइंग टू यू नो कॉल मी नेम्स दे विल द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम इज इफ आई कुड जस्ट टेक 1 मिनट ओके आई विल गिव यू आइसक्रीम अनुराग सर इज गोइंग टू गेट आइसक्रीम फॉर यू या राइट अवे सो जस्ट गिव मी 2 मिनट्स एंड देन आई विल कम See, this is a viewer. I am trying to say something else and what he wants is an ice cream aur usko chahiye ki bas ab Rubika Liaqat ice cream jo hai wo de de. Yeah, yeah.
Especially my deep cold love wo bahut mehengi mere dost ko shuru kiya. Dusra, I remembered a meme which is so relevant to what you said. See, it said, I read a meme that my daughter sent to me. That you can't make everyone happy. You're not ice cream.
Absolutely.
Journalists bhi hum ice cream nahi hai. Ki hum sabko khush kar paaye. Theek hai? Ki matlab, you know, it's not, and it is not possible. You can't please all the people in life, whether in personal life, in professional life, in public life. There'll be people who have a predisposed. And main kehna chahta hu, hamare saathi Rohit Sardana ka nidhan ho gaya. और उसके निधन के बाद लोग ऐसी चीजें ट्विटर पे लिख रहे हैं आई थिंक दे नीड काउंसलिंग उनको उनको कुछ मानसिक रोग है ऐसे लोगों को कि कोई चला गया उसका अभी क्या उसको क्या बोल रहे हो और क्या
मिस्टर बत्रा आई विल टेल यू समथिंग पीपल लाइक अस एंड आई एम श्योर आनंद विल रिलेट टू दिस एंड इवन आलोक जी ने इतना टाइम पत्रकारिता में अपना दिया है और आज जब मेरे शो में कभी हुंकार में आनंद जी माफ कीजिएगा आलोक जी बैठते हैं तो उनको भी कड़वी बातें की जाती है लेकिन अच्छी बात यह है कि आलोक जी के पास 2 पॉकेट्स है अगर विपक्ष के खिलाफ उनके पास रहस्य हैं तो वहां सरकार के खिलाफ भी रहस्य है तो यहाँ से अगर कोई कहने लगता है तो वो फौरन अपने दूसरे जेब में हाथ डालते हैं और कहते हैं ये देखो तुम्हारा किस्सा भी बता देता हूँ तो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट मुझे लगता है मैं और आनंद और मेरे जैसे तमाम जो पत्रकार हैं या प्रेजेंटर्स हैं जिनका अपनी सोच है वो एक नदी की तरह है धारा प्रवाह आप बहते जाए आप उसमें कोई पत्थर डालेगा रोहेल तो क्या हम रुक जाएंगे एबीपी न्यूज प्लीज डू वॉच एबीपी न्यूज दैट्स व्हाट ओजन इज ट्राइंग टू से सो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट उसमें कोई पत्थर फेंकेगा एक फेंके 10 फेंके या 50 फेंके क्या नदी बहना रुक जाएगी उसका काम है उस बड़े समंदर और वो बड़ा समंदर मेरे लिए जैसे आनंद कह रहे हैं हिंदुस्तान है आई नो वेयर द डेस्टिनेशन इज बेटरमेंट ऑफ आवर सोसाइटी एंड ऑफ आवर कंट्री अब उसमें किसी को पत्थर फेंकना है या भाला फेंकना है
राइट राइट मिस्टर नरसिम्हन टू यू 2 मिनट्स then I go to Dr. Batra for his final comment. You know, you spoke about how the new media is also giving you the opportunity of kind of having these multiple voices and then they kind of balance. What are the future forces that will define the newsroom, taking on from what Dr. Mehta ji has written in his book, you know, what are the forces that will dictate the terms in the newsroom?
I think reading and writing, Ruhir. See, Twitter is a base of 3 crore people in our country. We are a population of a nation of 135 crore plus. So how can Twitter decide who we are? Clubhouse is not less than, not more than about, say, 3 to 4 million people who are there. So how is Clubhouse going to decide how society thinks and how we think? What's going to happen is, I can only urge, and I always used to, but I think I have started reading more now, and the more I read, the more I'm able to understand. And it is credit to people like Sachidananda ji, to Alok Mehta ji, that they write. So the more people read, the more they will be inclined to write. These 3-minute shots, that's a bad trend. 3-minute shots are not the right trend. They are the current trend, but that's not the right trend. The future is digital. Television perhaps will somewhere become redundant. Newspaper writing or print, the way we see as in broadsheets, may not be there in the near future. But these broadsheets will go onto the digital platform. And there is so much to read. If people who spend, and our life is now inside this one phone, this one instrument, which is a phone. But there is so much information which is there. And if people can read, and if more people can write, and people would read different points of view, then perhaps we'd have a far more educated and a more open society, which also connects with our past. See, somewhere we don't read our past. We are not being taught about our past. We need to know where we are coming from to have a clarity about where we want to go. And I think that's what's going to happen. And I'm hoping somewhere amidst all of this artificial intelligence and bots, which are going to prompt you to see towards certain aspects, there will be, because it's such a huge apar ocean, there will be a balance. You will swing the pendulum here, you'll swing the pendulum there, but somewhere you will find that golden ratio, which is important. And that perhaps will happen. But for that, we need to encourage people to write more, read more, and then perhaps talk.
And I may say, a lot of people in television journalism actually came from print. I can give you 10 big examples. Not all, but I can say 60-70% initially. And I think you form a thought process. When you write, you learn, you research, you want to be sure. And in writing, brevity is the soul of wit, which also applies to television. So I think it's the content neutral form will take over. I just wanted to supplement what he said.
Right. And then final thoughts to you, Dr. Batra. Keeping in view of what Mr. Mehta has written, how do you see the future discourse around media? What would it be like?
Media ki credibility kam dikha ke fayda kisko hota hai? Sarkar ko hota hai. Sarkar media walon ko prostitutes bulati hai. Koi bhi sarkar, main sarkar ki akele ki baat nahi karta. Jaise Sachidanand Mootri ji ne bataya ki Ranjan Das Munshi and the minister say, and he tried to bring. So there are many examples. I think first of all, yes, we can enhance our reputation. There is some credibility loss. As a community that we've had, I think we need to bring it back. That's the honest submission, I would say some. I'm not talking any individual or organization. Second is to stay relevant. We also have to take up new areas of journalism or focus. For example, agar air quality sirf 2 mahine ke liye issue kyun hona chahiye? Air quality se bada important issue to kuch hai hi nahi. Hamare bachcho ko impact karti hai, humko impact karti hai, impacts lives, impacts livelihood. So why should we not focus more and more on environmental issues? Why are we not focusing a lot on mental well-being, which we started to post-COVID? Ye do mudde bahut bade mudde hai. Right? We also have to focus on we all have become screen agents. We're not teenagers. But what is more screen time doing to all of us? What is it doing to our children? Right? So point I want to make is that for journalism to reinvent itself, it will also go deeper into areas that we sometimes take as, only once, twice a year when there is a crisis, right? Second, there has to be a more follow-up. Media has become an activist in some way and takes up issues till they're brought to logical conclusion through a judicial process or some other action. But we have to, for example, I talked of environment. अभी फिर एयर क्वालिटी का इश्यू आ जाएगा कुछ महीने में फिर हम 2 महीना शोर मचाएंगे और चले जाएंगे तो आई थिंक मेकिंग श्योर दैट दिस एक्टिविज्म लीड्स टू एक्शन आई थिंक वी हैव टू बिकम लाइक दैट सम ओनिंग एन इश्यू ओनिंग अ स्टोरी एंड क्रिएटिंग एन इम्पैक्ट एंड अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल ऑन दिस पैनल डू दैट इन देयर ओन लास्ट माई थिंग इज वॉट आनंद सेड वी आर सी If we want to be relevant in an era where there's social media, where there are individuals who have their point of view and can disseminate, we'll have to be sharper, we'll have to be differentiated. And last but not the least, we'll have to be more honest than we are. I have to say that's what I feel. And it's not a commentary on anyone on this panel, but it's a commentary on myself. I talk to myself. This is me talking to me. We have to be more honest. That's what I'd say. And I'd like to congratulate Dr. Mehta ji again on his book. And I would like all of us to hold it once again, because that is...
Absolutely. One more.
Yes.
The screen version of a group picture. Absolutely.
Thank you very much, Raji.
I'm giving company to Mr. Narasimhan here, right? So... congratulations again, sir, Mehta ji, for this wonderful book. Itni lambi conversation, hum 60 se 90 minutes chale gaye, and still I think it could have gone longer, but we'll surely have more such discussions. And thank you for joining us today, everyone on this panel, and to the young reader who joined us at the end. Thank you, everyone.
I'm so sorry for that.
No, not at all. No, great to see him here. And thank you.
Final words, Aluk ji, if you'd like to say a few words about the book, and we can wrap up.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Sabko bahut dhanyawad. Shukriya. Adab.
Thank you. Aluk ji, papa ki taraf se aapko ek message hai. वो ये कह रहे हैं कि आप इसको जरा हिंदी में भी आप पब्लिश करवा दीजिए, ताकि ज्यादा से ज्यादा मासेस तक ये किताब पहुंच सके.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, मैं तो, जरूर सब देख रहे हैं परिवार वाले, उनको भी कार्य.
ऑलराइट, थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू.
ऑलराइट ऑलराइट,
कमेंडेशंस रोहिल, वेल मोटिवेटेड. I'd like to extend on behalf of all the panelists, thank you very much for doing this and for having us here. Anurag ji, thank you for thinking of us. Very humbled. Aluk ji and Sachidanand ji. Rupika, always a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for joining.